My name is Ms. Osborne, and we're going to talk a lot today about how the train changed everything in North Carolina. So between 1800 till about 1830, people were leaving North Carolina in droves because there was not a good road system, jobs were not as plentiful as they used to be, and cities were not connected like they were in neighboring states such as Tennessee, Virginia, and South Carolina. And a lot of families moved away from the state for economic reasons. But everything changed probably around 1830 when railroads and better roads themselves started to come into existence, connecting the eastern and western parts of the state for commerce. Now, a little bit about farming. We have farms, and farmers make money by selling their crops. Yes, some farmers use their land to feed themselves, and that's called sustainable farming, but you don't make any money or extra money if you just feed your family. And what happened was there was greater and greater demand for more goods and services when after the railroads came in, and this is 1840, 1845. And more people want goods and services, so farmers are finding that they have to produce more. And when they found that they had to produce more, they went to what products would bring them the most profit. And then they learned, well, if I use all my land for tobacco, which became a huge crop in North Carolina, Duke University came into existence because of the American Tobacco Company, which was owned by the Duke family, and cotton mills, which were situated next to rivers. Because of, does anyone know why they were situated next to rivers and waterways and ponds?
You're
on the right track. So what would happen is that the water would power the machinery, which would power the machines. And this was very important before electricity. So we had mill factories, and six new mills came into existence in the latter part of the 19th century, and that's the 1800s. So suddenly, North Carolina became transformed. Things were going all right. Then the Civil War happened. Now, North Carolina was already kind of poor. It wasn't a rich state like Virginia or South Carolina, and there were still many, many families that depended upon their existence for farms. Well, what happened was that the men went off to war. They left the farms behind. The women and children and older men had to take care of the farms. They did the best they could. But without the extra manpower, many of these farms collapsed. Why did you park me by the barn on that old Chatham County farm? I must new paint, new shocks. Please remove my blocks. We fix the leaks and we stop the squeaks. But I can't roll, nowhere to go except to feel the ghost gripping my wheel. Bob traces the rain along the window pane. Forgets about the cans and the chain link frame. I sleep to the crickets in twilight, missing his voice. Light like rust, yet smoked with whiskey, whiskey and dust. Why did you park me by the barn on that old Chatham County farm? Well, I miss new paint, new shocks. Please remove my blocks. We fix the leaks and we stop the squeaks. But I can't go nowhere to go except to
feel the ghost gripping my wheel. Bob crosses my flat tires, scuffed in the grass. Circles of time repeating so fast. I sleep to the crickets in twilight, a new V8 engine under my hood. We worked so well together and everything was good. Why did you park me by the barn on that old Chatham County farm? Though I miss new paint, new shocks. Please remove my blocks. Oh, we fix the leaks and we stop the squeaks. But I can't roll. Nowhere to go except to feel the ghost gripping my wheel.
Use your imagination to write down what do you think happens to the barn and what do you think happens to the truck. And if you want, you can write about what do you think happens to the Bob. Bob is the owner of the truck. Is Carolina Star, and it's about a woman who is working at the factory to help raise her children, provide income for her family, and her husband is pursuing his dream, and that dream is playing music in Nashville. And he did that at a great expense because he could also be working in the factory as a repairman, but he decided not to, and his hope is that he'll come back.
Back in those hills, those cold rolling hills, North Carolina comes close to the stars. Living in a lady and she's shining so high, they call her the Carolina Star. Works in a factory from Monday to Friday, raising three daughters all alone. Daddy's away and he is chasing a dream, waiting for the day that he comes home.
Who would like to share? I can take maybe three friends to share some of their responses. So who would like to share their first response? And that is for the tobacco barn. And the question was, what do you think happens to the truck, the barn, or Bob? You had your hand up first.
Was the truck was thinking about the old time it had with its owner, and what I think happened to the tobacco is that it didn't have enough money to get more tobacco seed, so it couldn't produce what it wants. And the last one is about Bob. He didn't have any money, so I think.
I think you're right. I think you're right. Yeah. Very good. Good job. Yes.
I was going to shoot for the next one.
Okay. Young man in the blue jacket.
The barn keeps getting the tobacco.
You think the barn's going to get more tobacco?
and the truck is going to get a little rusty.
Yeah, I think the truck's going to get rusty too. I agree.
I think the barn is going to get knocked down.
Okay.
Into something new.
Uh huh.
The truck is going to get repaired, and Bob drives it around and helps the backhoe get in the machine.
Okay. I love that. I love that. I think I really agree with you on the first one. I think it's going to turn into maybe a vintage store. I mean, it could be converted, and that happens to a lot of barns. They're getting converted into lofts, apartments, condos, and a lot of times stores. So maybe Bob will become a store owner.